Hi everyone and welcome back. Let's get started with the next set of questions. And here we are going to play around with an array object, some simple ones. Okay, so this is our object which has been given to us in interview, and they want us to manipulate it based on some conditions. Like you wanted to change the name of every object inside this array. So what we simply do is we start iterating. And here we are doing a manipulation in array index, not filtering. So we can use simple map. Okay, so here const new data set, and what change we have to do is we have to update this name property with something else for all the array objects, right? So we can just use events dot map. We can do in the map, we will iterate each and every element. Okay, and what we are going to return from here is, so here first we will check if particular iteration dot name exists. Okay, yes, name exists there. Then we will return, we will update the value e with something else. Here we are doing spread operator. This is my current object. Sorry, this is our I. Okay, I will just append the name property with something else. Consider new name. Okay, and I will return I. That means I iterate through this object. Okay, and I'm just updating this name property to the new name, and I'm getting array back. This is what map operator does. Now we can also do filter, because map filter reduce can run in a chain. In the filter, what I want to do is, if I dot name, I dot metadata, first of all, I dot metadata, and I dot metadata dot type. Okay, if this equals to, you can say public, then only return this. So you can say, you can simply say, I mean, instead of doing this, you can return from here. If this is true, that is fine. If it is false, it will not return that index. Now we got the filter. So using filter, we will get this object only. Okay. Now you can just print that object. So finally, in the new data, we are having this object only. So this is only about like manipulating the data. You have given employee data with salary, grades and all. Now you are doing a filtering, updating some particular property and doing filtering, and again doing a reduce. Like if you wanted to finally calculate the sum of all the employee salary, whatever is in the array, right? Or you wanted to do the sorting of it, like consider that you have multiple elements and you have some more property, which is you can say ID, which is a number for all the array. Now you want a result as a filtered one. Okay, I need to put this. So every object has an ID also, and we want to do the sorting, right? So we can, this is again an array of objects, we can do a sort. And here we are doing sorting based on some property. So we got two properties. Here we will just say, let's say the question is convert these IDs into the numbers and then convert it, right? So we can say parseInt of B minus parseInt of A. You already know that sort method is powerful, and it is going to do the sorting based on your function. Parse B minus A means it will do the descending order. Parse A minus B means it will do the sorting based on the ascending order, right? So all these elements 789, 790. So it will be in the ascending order, okay? So these can be as general questions to just know what do you know about array prototype methods, slice, splice, push, pop, map, filter, reduce, all these methods. Okay, in the previous video we talked about rotations and all. Now let's talk about another question. So I will be actually grouping 2-3 questions in a video, which can be correlated to one another or can be a totally different problem. Okay, in this what I want to do is I want to return maximum occurring element. Okay, like here I have a const array, and in this maximum occurring element you can see let's increase 5 more times. So 5 is coming in the 3 times. Okay, so const max count, it should be simple, like we are passing an array. What we can do is we can actually do the sorting first. I will just do the copy of it, array dot sort, and I will just pass two arguments a and b, and I will be returning b minus a. Okay, so let's say descending order sorting I have done. Okay, so we got the sorted array. Now I will get the maximum of it, I mean maximum element out of an array, which we can do using math dot max math dot max, and you just pass an array. Array, we already have array 1. Okay, I got lot of elements, it's array 1. Okay, now let's talk about how we can do this. So what we will do is we will iterate onto the array length, okay, and whatever is maximum occurring. Okay, so like here we got an array and it has indexes, we got the max element also. So we'll iterate onto the element and we'll compare each value with the max. Okay, so what we can do is for let I with 0, I is less than array 1 dot length, okay, here we can do the if max equal to array of I. That means we got the maximum element reoccurring, right? Finally, what we can say is if array of I less than max, then break. So we just need to return how many times a maximum element is reoccurring, right? Like here the 56 is the max element, right? So here we are just trying to calculate how many times the max element is reoccurring, right? So it should be simple. So we sorted the array in the reverse order, so we can get the max element in the starting. Okay, 56. Even if you are getting 56 multiple times, it will be something like this, right? In that case, it should return 56, and that is coming 3 times, right? So max we are comparing with array of I, and whenever we start getting any lesser numbers from the max element, that means 56 is not going to come again because we have done the reverse sorting, right? And that's it. Here we got our result. It will give us what is the max element. Max we already got. Either you can return an object, we already know what is max, and we already got a result. Okay, this is just to check how many times the array max element is repeating. Now we have already talked about the mutation. Here we are not changing the existing array. Using map filter reduce, you are always going to get a new array. Okay, array max min we have already done. So array flattening, that is another important question. You might have seen this. When you have a nested array like something like this, because this is possible in JavaScript, okay, so it's like deep nested, and you want to do a flattening so that you can get 1 2 3 4 5 6 6 7 8 9. Okay, So you can write a simple method, or there is a flatten method also available in JavaScript. Flatten and pass the infinity. So it will take care of the flattening of your array. I'll just talk about directly the answer of it, because we already talked about it. So there are many solutions you can do with a simple recursion. This is approach one. I already have a code snippet ready for this. Okay, what we are doing is we are concatenating it, right? So we are running a loop onto this array. Okay, and we are checking if array is an array, then do this, otherwise that is not an array. So if you see, we are just going to iterate the first index. Okay, 1 is not an array, 1 is just a simple element, 2 is also simple element, 3 is also simple element. Here we start getting array. So that means if array dot array is array for that element, then we will recursively call this and we will try to flatten this. Otherwise we will just concat the element, which is 1 2 3. Now again it will call it, then it will recursively call it, so it will flat this and we will get the final array, because all are doing a concat operation. Or you can do the reduce is the same method which keeps adding on the values received from the previous iteration. Array dot reduce, flat is the function and yet to be flattened. Okay, so it initialized with empty array. Flat dot concat, yet to be flattened is an array, then it will just recall it recursively, otherwise it will just concat the element. Okay, and flat we initialized with empty array. So there are many possible ways of doing it. You can just do a recursive call and try to do this. Okay, so let's see a few more questions in next videos. Thanks everyone.